Alrighty, people. I haven't done a commentary in quite a while. Not really doing much. There's not many people on PvP. I mean, if I go to my other campaign, there's no one there. So, not been doing any PvP. I did just respec my points. So I have 119. I figured I'd start from scratch. I'm wondering how many I can save. I only had 3 left over. With my regular build, but considering now I don't use a lot of these skills, I think I'm just gonna start over again. Okay. So, I don't use that ultimate, so I probably won't get that. I definitely use this. Take the morph puncturing sweeps. Now, I've done this before where I've accidentally taken the wrong morphs for some things and having to start over, so I'm gonna try not to do that. No, don't want that one. Alright. Let's assign it to that, even though I don't actually use it there. Focus charge, I actually have morphed, and I don't use that, so I'm not going to put points into that. Blazing spear, definitely need a sun shield, which I go into a blazing shield. Let's go ahead and assign that to that. Blazing spear goes here. And of course, all the freaking morphs to this. Amazing. All of these passives. Weapon damage by 3%, weapon damage by 6%, spell resistance. Amazing. Can't not have those. Okay, so already saved like 4 skill points right there. Let's go on to the next one. Nova, I don't really use. I could use, but I don't really. All right. I do, however, use that, and I've tried both morphs. This one just deals more damage over time, but this one affects multiple targets, and I really do like that, because a lot of the enemies in this game are in groups, and it's just better. Especially when you're playing PvP and there's a lot of people. You know what, honestly, I don't really use Dark Flare, which is the morph I take for this, so I'll actually, for now, I'll just, I mean, if I ever need to use it, I'll buy it, but as for right now, I don't actually need that. Nope, don't want anything that scales off my stamina. I don't use any stamina. I don't use that ability. Radiant Destruction, I definitely do. And I take the morph that just deals up to 40% more damage in proportion to my magic. But it's my current magic, not my max magic. So, as long as you have a lot of magic all the time, then you do more damage. This one just heals you, which also is good. I just want to do more damage. And then, of course, the duration of the abilities are 20% longer. You know what? I almost don't even want to take this. Because, I mean, I guess ultimate is nice, but... Spell damage for 5% for 20 seconds. Reduces magicka stamina and ultimate ability cost by 2%. That's a big one right there. Of course, you gotta be level 50 to get it all the way maxed out. Restoring light, I do use that ultimate. And I take it to where it has a longer duration. Yes, bring it to Breath of Life. Love it. I don't really even... I guess every once in a while I do use Repentance. It doesn't cost anything to have. Cleansing Ritual, I do use. Has extended duration by... Well, this one doesn't even tell me how long it lasts. Hold on. For 12 seconds. This one's for 16 seconds. Even though the duration says 14 seconds, but whatever. That's... weird on there. But I do this one. It reduces costs and removes even more effects. Instead of removing 2, I think it removes 5. Although having a certain duration, that's pretty nice. Nah, reduce cost. It's 600 less magic. I need that. Rune, I don't use that. This one makes it to where you can heal more. Increases the healing effects. Yes. Oh, this one just helps freaking everything. This one, so I need one more level. I'm level 49 and I need to get level 50 to get the next level to that. That's going to be awesome. Two-handed, I actually started using, but now that I don't need to use it anymore. Defensive posture, I don't really use. If I do end up using it, I'll take it, but no. Add stun duration. Both of them say 2 seconds, so I don't know how long it increases the stun duration on, so I might as well just take Shield Assault. Reduces the cost. Yeah, I do like that, because now it costs less. Weapon damage increased by 3%. Hell yes. Standard bat. No, don't use bashes. Amount of damage you can block from projectiles. Definitely. Movement speed while blocking. I wish I had longer time to make videos because of YouTube's like 15-minute cutoff time, unless you have like a super awesome special face, then you only get 15 minutes to make videos, and I think I've already run through about 5 minutes right now. I just looked at my wrist, and I don't have a watch on. That was really weird, and considering you can't see that, I don't know why I did that. A lot of the times when I use this, I don't even need the increased range, and the added elemental effects would be really nice, because instead of it just knocking back, because I mainly use flame damage, it would knock back and stun them. And this one, I mean, but increased range is really nice, because when you're in PvP and you want to hit someone from far away, 28 meters is a really freaking long distance. It's actually the longest distance spell that I have. And it's a big difference between 17 and 28. So I do either do, like, I can stun them, but I'll be up close, or just, you know what, just increase range. I'm waiting to get this at level 38. Apparently it sounds pretty awesome, because it's an area of effect, and you can constantly cast it. As opposed to the rest of these, I'm not really that interested in. Yes, I do want that, because heavy attacks do more. Ledger destruction spell to ignore. Why not? Increases the spell's chance of afflicting with burning effects. Reduces the time to... Actually, I didn't even know I had this. There we go. Reduces the time it takes to charge a heavy attack by 5%. Restoration staff I don't use currently now, so I will keep all of those open. Light armor, hell yes on every single thing. Because I usually use 5 light, and then I think I have like 1 medium and 1 heavy right now. But always have 5 light no matter what. Stamina recovery, I usually put 2 into that, just in case I have any that are heavy. I didn't actually have anything into. So I could, but I don't always have one. I always have 1 medium. I either have 1 medium or 2 medium, but I don't always have 1 heavy. So I'll leave that for that. Soul magic, definitely soul strike, the big crushing murder. See, if a target is killed, it explodes. The only thing is, when I use this, typically they don't die. The only time I'm using this ultimate is if I'm against a really, really powerful enemy, and most of the time, they don't die. So, soul trap, I don't use enough. Revive myself once every 2 hours without using a soul gem. I do take that. I'll probably end up taking... Nah, I won't take another one. I'll probably actually take this. If your health drops below 20%, you explode. It's just nice for PvP when you get down, or I guess in general, if you get below 20%, which is every once in a while. Don't use any of those. Intimidate, yes. Weapon, yeah, sure, why not? Because you do battle quite a bit of Daedra in this game. No, don't care about that. This is an important one. Allows your fighter guild abilities that affect Daedra also affect werewolves, and a lot of people do use werewolves in PvP. Don't use any of those. Assault, I do use rapid maneuver, and I morph it to retreating maneuver. Oh yes, hell yes on all 3 of these. Max magic and max stamina, flame resistance and max magicka, and then spell damage with flame effects. Alright, big other one is provisioning. 5 minutes of the duration, 10 minutes of the duration. I don't have 15 minutes yet. Creates one extra serving of each food recipe. I'm about to get another one where it's, 2 servings. I don't use drinks, so I don't need any of that other stuff. And that's it. Now I have 24 left over. I mean, now I've got... I could, like... Now I can actually do this, where I, you know, gain ultimate when I use Dawn Wrath abilities. You know, got everything there. One hand, one shield. I guess I could get defensive postures just to have it, but... Don't use that. Destruction. Restoration is the only other thing that... Hold on, what's that final thing? Healing with restoration staff spells. See, now when I go into... Well, you know what? Actually, I do use this because when I go into group play, I do use that for group play, because this is actually really, really good, because it's a big, big area, and you get mana, wow, that's this wrong game, you get magicka back if you heal allies in the area. So, actually do that, increase health by 8%, under allies of 30% health. This one is the most important thing ever in the whole freaking world. Restores 30% of your magicka when you complete a heavy attack. That's the main reason people use restoration staffs. If you don't care for that, and you don't really, if you don't really find yourself being out of magicka that much, which everyone does, and you're lying in your poopy face if you don't, then you would use a destruction staff. Which is what I'm currently using now, just because I'm getting tired of the restoration staff. Even though I'm at level 45 with it, and I'm almost done, but... Still. Restores magicka when you block a spell. And this one increases healing with restoration staff spells. Which is great. Which really, I don't really need unless you're doing group play, because healing springs is what I use. But other than that, hell, everything... I mean, I guess I could put some into heavy, because I do have a piece of heavy on right now, but it's only one piece. I guess I'll take this. My health drops below 20%. It deals... Oh, hell. Let's take part two of that. Soul Trap. There's no need to morph. Either it affects an additional target, or it also restores resources when the enemy dies. It restores 7% of blah, 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 blah. So, eh. But you know, I don't use it enough to where I would need that. So I got 10 points left over. I mean, I got 10 free points. And now let's, I'll show you how I... This is the setup that I use. I'll switch that to... What do I use for that? Now I don't even know. Oh, god dang it. Oh, that's what it is. Duh. It's because it's been there since, like, level 15. I don't even realize what it is. All right, now let's swap. For this, I use Breath of Life. That's my go-to... healing. That's my go-to healing button. Circle is Retreating Maneuver. So I need to run away. I also swap it out with Purifying Ritual, depending on if I'm in a PvP area, I'll switch Purifying Ritual with Retreating Maneuver. This is my flex spot. Triangle could be anything. Sometimes I'll have Repentance. Sometimes I'll have Reflective Light or Blazing Shield is my favorite. That way I have Blazing Shield on both bars, just so I can always counter. L1 is always Radiant Oppression, and it deals 300 times more damage when the enemy is low health, which is around 50% health, which is pretty good, maybe even 40%, but yeah. This one is also kind of a flex spot. I either use the Javelin or the Blazing Spear, but since I already have the Blazing Spear on my Sword and Shield, I'm going to go ahead and take the Javelin, because this build is, when I'm using my staff, is mostly for if I need to get people away. Actually, you know what, screw that. I already have, the triangle is going to be my destructive reach, because that actually knocks people back. And if I already have a knockback, I don't need the javelin. So I'm going to take an area of effect and go with the blazing spear. Now for the ultimate, I'll use soul assault, because using soul assault and then getting their health down to at least 50%, if not less, then using radiant oppression, they're just going to die. Because once they have low health and you hit them with this, they're guaranteed to die. I haven't hit anybody with this with low health and hasn't died unless they're spam healing themselves. Unless they use an ultimate, like if they're using practice incarnation or incantation, not incarnation.